They are fun, lightweight, and great to look at. Let's take a moment and celebrate these sport coupes from the 60s and 70s. Automobiles that were the precursors to today's modern sport compacts. did it! You won the Forza Drivers Cup. You're a part of racing history now. If you finish the remaining races in this or any championship, you'll get something, well, rather special. But there's no rush. Enjoy this victory for as long as you want.
Time that you're behind, there's always a frustration or an anger, so you're trying to catch back up or get around the guy ahead of you, and really getting mad generally creates more mistakes. So you lose a bit of really your sensitivity for grip and that sort of thing when you're driving with anger. Trying.
To me, what makes a car special is kind of the way that it feels. So I have to feel connected to it. I have to feel it in the seat of my pants, connected to the road, connected to the ground. It has to be a car that I feel like I can make go fast. I actually say sometimes that nowadays cars are too easy to drive because you can't feel, you know, in the steering wheel what the car is doing and where it's at and kind of the balance of it, because cars are sometimes built to be comfortable. So I like a
Yeah, it's the Aston Martin Vulcan. That's the ultimate giant uncorked 7-liter V12. I dare you to find me a better sounding car. We'll be right back.
Yeah, autocross is one of those great entry-level ways to get into motorsports. It's one of those forms of motorsport that anybody in any car can really try. With your car and have to.
Endurance racing these days is like a giant sprint race, and there is no taking it easy until the last hour of the race where you're going to go at it. You may not take the same risks in hour one as you would in the last hour, but it's definitely become so uber competitive that it's just a full-on sprint race. It's not like, oh, we're just going to drive around.
You know, exotics are exactly what they sound like. I mean, they're sort of the most extreme expression of what an automaker can do from a design standpoint and from a mechanical standpoint and from a driver experience standpoint. But they're the, you know, they're the cars that everybody dreams of owning, and, you know, they're the...
At 100 miles an hour, you're still feeling pretty much in a normal driving situation. It's not too loud. The car has a lot of inertia, so you know you have to be smooth with the inputs, but you still can be hard on the brakes and you can still move the car around just a little bit. At 150, suddenly wind noise takes over, and that's when you really know you're starting to push it.
My dad was a Ford truck guy, so I grew up going to the racetrack with my dirt bike in the back of a Ford truck and just sharing that passion that my dad had when I was quite young for the vehicle and for the local.